help. Hi, friend. I'm hereby to show you how you can fill your jamb form, registration form, good and clean without any mistake, because a lot of people made a lot of mistakes last year. They have a confusion on their jamb registration form, which is not their fault, because they don't really see someone who can guide them how to fill their form before they have before they fall into a victim of that. Maybe a mistake with your surname, or a mistake with your date of birth, a mistake with your institution, a mistake with your marital status, a mistake with your disability or anything, or a mistake with your passport. But I got to show you how you can fill the form perfectly without no error. So first thing you got to start with is your surname. As you can see here, we have surname bracket family name. Your surname simply means your last name, which is the name of your father, which is will be there at the label there. Then we have the middle name. The middle name means your name, which is given to you after the first name. And your first name is already there too. You got to put your name you bear in school, your name your parents called you, which is the first name. Now we have spent the surname and the middle name and the first name. Now let's go to the date of birth. You put exactly date of birth of your wife. There is no forging in jamb registration form. You got to put the date of your wife, because when you got for your screening in the school, your institution you choose, they got to cross-check your jamb registration portal and the WAEC result you submit. So that is why you got to be carefully putting your date of birth of your certificate, which is maybe the day, that is the day 03, for instance, the month, that's March, May, January, then the year, which is 1991 or 1993 or whatever, then the sex, XEX, which is the sex, either you are a male or a female, you put it there. Then disability. Disability simply means maybe you are handicapped, or maybe you are blind, or maybe you are physically not fit, or maybe you have any challenges in your body. You got to put it there. But if you don't have anything, you put none. N-O-N-E, none. Then marital status simply means maybe you are married or divorced or single. Single or married or divorced, you put it there. If you are single, you put the single. If you are married, you put the married. If you are divorced, you put the divorce, man. So your postal address. Your postal address simply means the address where you stay. This is a lot of mistake where people make mistake. This is the address where you stay, is your postal address. That is where you are living, where your parents is living, where you stay. That's what they call your postal address. You fill your postal address there. Then we have the address town. Address town simply means the town. Now I'm staying at Songo, for instance. And then the town is Ibadan, and that is it. So when you're staying maybe in Abuja, you put your town. When you're staying in River State, you put the town, which is Port Harcourt. When you're staying in the state you're staying, which is the town of the state. Then we also have the country and the state. That is, you put the state slash the country. River State slash Nigeria, Lagos slash Nigeria, Bell slash Nigeria, or wherever where you're staying among Nigeria. Then we have an email. Now it has been specific out that all user, all candidates to have a activate email, because this email is where you are going to send all your details, where you are going to send everything about you, and where you are going to be validated. This email is very crucial, it's very vital. So you need a email that is active. So you put your email, be it at Gmail, be it at Yahoo Mail, be it at Hotmail. Just make a provision of email which is active. Then your mobile number, which is your phone number, you put a phone number that is well recognized as active, but your phone number 070, for instance, or any kind, Etisalat, MTN, anyone you are using, you put it there. Then we have nationality. Nationality simply means are you a Nigerian or are you a Egyptian or anything you are. When you're a Nigerian, you put the Nigerian there. Then we have the state of origin, the state where you were from, the state where your father from. That is what you're talking about. It's not the state you are living. You may be living in River State and you're from Ibadan. You may be living in Ibadan and you are from Lagos. You may be living in Akwara State and you are from Maiduguri. So the state you're from, that's what they call the state of origin. They are the local government you're from, that is the local government you came from, that's what they call the local government, LGA, local government area. That is your local government, so they filled there. Then, preferred state of exam. Where do you want to write your jamb? That's what they mean. Preferred state of exam simply means where you want to write your jamb. The state you want to write it, be it River State, be it Benue, be it Kwara State, anywhere you want to write your exam, you'll be fixed there. And the town of the place you want to write the exam. If it is River State, I put River State. And if it is Port Harcourt, I put Port Harcourt at the stand. So that is everything about your personal information. And now we are going to the crucial area that we need to explain. There's a candidate are to note that their one choice can also be College of Education, University, Innovation Enterprises Institution, or Polytechnic, NDA, or Nigeria Defense Academy or Nigeria Police Academy. So what does this simply mean? Simply means they are talking about the most preferred choice, which is your degree, ND or NCE. That is, you got to put maybe your university. Even you got to attend university, you got to put your university. Maybe I want to attend University of Port Harcourt. I got to put it University of Port Harcourt. And I want to read a course called Geology. I got to put a course under there, man. So now you got to understand everything they are trying to show you in this place, because it's very crucial and very vital. Now let's go to the second page paragraph. We have the most preferred institute, their ND, that is a national diploma. You got to understand what is meant. I have already chosen your degree. This is the national diploma. This is the polytechnic. That is number two. You got to label the polytechnic, maybe Polytechnic of Ibadan or Polytechnic of Port Harcourt or Polytechnic of any state. Just make sure that the polytechnic is fixed in this second paragraph and the course you want to read there. So let's go to the third most preferred choice, which is your NCE, your College of Education. You got to put your College of Education and the course you want to study there. And we have the last one, which is IEI, Innovative Enterprises Institution. That is, Innovative Enterprises Institution are institution with a 2 years course, maybe paralegal, those people who connote with lawyers, and some certificate courses. Those are the sample of innovative institution. Now, would you like to take option of mock? The mock exam is not compulsory. It may be the first time you attend the jamb and you try to exercise your brain. You got to take it, or you don't want to take it. Mock exam simply means the same thing as the CPT training. So if you like to take it, you say yes. If you like, don't want to take it, you say no. So then we come to your O level. Your O level is your WAEC or your NECO. Your O level is your WAEC or your NECO. So you can also fail two results. You can combine your results by checking the one you failed and replacing the one you passed. So I want to combine my results. For instance, maybe I have F9 mathematics in WAEC and I have C6 in NECO. I will put at number one C6 mathematics, and I will label it at the top here as WAEC/NECO. And two seats, grade, which is a C6 or D or E or F9 or anything you got, you got to put it there. Two sitting allow maximum. That is the only thing. Then you come to your UTME subject, the subject you want to partake. If you are reading law, you know the subject you need. If you are reading doctor, you know the subject you need. If you are reading anything you want to do, you know the subject you need. For instance, maybe I want to go for doctor, I got to put English is compulsory, physics number 2, chemistry number 3, and biology number 4. So that is all about how you can fill your form without no error and without no mistake. Thank you for watching this video and subscribe more. Bye.